Thanks, Jeff. I'm standing outside the Rodine Mansion where the fire happened yesterday. Our reporter Kenny Eddy has been looking into it. Kenny, can you tell me what happened here yesterday?
Emergency services were called to the property after those in the area reported plumes of smoke billowing from the property behind us, which is called Rodine House. And emergency services did a good job. They were here within 2 minutes on the scene and dealt with the blaze at the rear of the building, where there was smoke rising up well above. People could see it from miles around, and they were quickly on the scene, six units, and the emergency services, police and ambulances were also called to the scene. We were speaking to those earlier, and we can hear what they had to say about the fire on when they saw it firsthand.
I was just working down the road and we heard the fire alarm go off, and then a big puff of white smoke, then it turned to black smoke, and then we knew something was serious. And I don't know who, but someone called the fire engines, but because it's only around the corner, they were really quick. And then within 10 minutes, it was just crazy up here. And apparently it's burnt a few of his cars out. That's as much as I know.
So I heard that there were some explosions or some popping noises. Do you think those were the cars?
Possibly, yeah. Probably the engines of the cars, but because he's got an underground car park, apparently. But that was it, really.
Okay. Do you know if anyone was injured in the fire? I mean, this house has been dubbed the best in Brighton and Hove. So is there any suspicion, that it might have been a malicious arson attack?
Yes, it's a very affluent area. Multi-million pound houses, mansions surrounding us here. Police and emergency services, ambulances managed to pull a male in his 20s from the property and take him to the Royal Sussex County Hospital because of smoke inhalation and burns. He has later been questioned by the police on suspicion of arson, so we'll have to wait and see as to what the conclusion from the police is on that.
Right, thank you, Kenny. Back to you, Jeff.